To bury a loved one, and irrespective, they do not want Travis's money.
Hi, my name is Latrice. I live in New York City, by the way, in Manhattan. The families, I feel, are right. They shouldn't take the money, because if they do, this is not going to bring their family member, their loved one, back. Travis Scott should have known the assignment from the past concerts of everything that happened, him getting in trouble with the riots of the past concerts. This shouldn't have happened. You know, the police chief actually went to the trailer, talked to him. Something should have been done from the get-go. So, yeah, I feel what the parents are thinking. We're not going to accept this money from you because, no, you're not going to get out of this. And we want more than this. And you're not buying us off. And I believe that's
how they feel. Again, this wouldn't in any way preclude a lawsuit. It's just, I think, it goes deeper than that. What else you guys want?
The victims of the Astroworld tragedy have been rebuked time and time again. We told you about Ezra Blunt, the 9-year-old. His family said they did not want any money from Travis Scott to cover funeral expenses.
Well, that family's not alone.
Yeah, there are several other families who are taking the same path, and they are rejecting any assistance from Travis.
And what's interesting about this is that taking the money would not affect a lawsuit unless they specifically waive further claims against Travis and Astroworld and all the others. Yeah. So presumably he would just be giving them the money and they could still sue, but they still don't want
it.
It goes way deeper.
Well, I think these families are looking for compensation, but when they get it, they want it to go through court. They're not going to be taking anything now. And Travis Scott and his legal team have lawsuits up to their necks right now. So they're definitely going to, the families will definitely be getting something. Just right now, they're steering clear of Travis because, frankly, they don't want anything to do with him right now.
Yeah, I think that's right. I think it's more than about the lawsuit. In fact, I don't think
it's not on an emotional level.
It doesn't have anything to do with
the attorneys for one of the families told us that, you know, it just, you'd imagine, as you said, as you can imagine, if you lost your child and you feel that someone whose actions led to you losing your child, why would you want any connection with them whatsoever?
I mean, we don't know their financial circumstances, and, you know, it costs money to bury a loved one. And irrespective, they do not want Travis's money.
Yeah. Hi, my name is Latrice. I live in New York City, by the way, in Manhattan. The families, I feel, are right. They shouldn't take the money because if they do, this is not going to bring their family member, their loved one, back. Travis Scott should have known the assignment from the past concerts of everything that happened, him getting in trouble with the riots of the past concerts. This shouldn't have happened. You know, the police chief actually went to the trailer, talked to him. Something should have been done from the get-go. So, yeah, I feel what the parents are thinking. We're not going to accept this money from you because, no, you're not going to get out of this. And we want more than this. And you're not buying us off. And I believe that's
how they
feel.
Again, this wouldn't in any way preclude a lawsuit. It's just, I think, like you said, I think it goes deeper than that. What else you guys